Despite giving up 12 goals in the last two games, Henrik Lundqvist still had the complete confidence of his coach, Alain Vigneault. He said, "Hank's our guy." How would Lundqvist perform in game four at Amalie Arena?
Hank was busy early. 4 minutes in, Nikita Kucherov off the faceoff all alone, and he completely misses the net. Look at this. How does that go so far off target? Now Tampa Bay power play, a little past 8 minutes in. Tyler Johnson off the crossbar. So explosive in the postseason. 12 goals so far in the playoffs, but that one just misses. Just under 3 minutes left in the period now.
Now Hayes with a lead pass for Rick Nash. Moves to the net and scores!
What a play by Carl Hagelin. Watch him kick the puck. Kicks it right there to Hayes. And Nash going down the wing protects the puck well with his big body and then slides it past Bishop.
Nash's first goal of the series is the icebreaker. His last goal, game six of the Washington series. Now to the second, 2 minutes in, Tampa on a power play. Alex Killorn with a breakaway. How about that stretch pass? He can't get it past Henrik Lundqvist. Victor Hedman with a strike all the way down the ice, but Lundqvist able to protect the lead. Moments later, Nikita Nesterov denied. Look at that collective effort. White shirts flying in all over. The Rangers protecting the net. Now 5 minutes later, Steven Stamkos to Alex Killorn. Another great chance foiled. This one wide. Now just under 9 minutes left in the period.
Here's Filppula right circle. Valtteri Filppula slips to Killorn right circle. High slap, Stamkos, score! A bomb! We're tied at one with 8:30 left in the second.
Stammer time again. Sixth goal of the playoffs, third goal in three games. Under 5 minutes, the Rangers would respond.
Now Yandle across for a shot, saved by Bishop, and then they score. It's knocked in by Kreider. 2-1 Rangers.
Team leading seventh of the postseason. That's getting to the dirty areas. Less than 2 minutes later, Keith Yandle letting her rip. It's off of Victor Hedman and into the net. This shot would have gone well wide, but instead ricochets off of Hedman's shin and into the cage past Ben Bishop. 3-1, Rangers heading to the third. 5 minutes in, Nikita Nesterov called for that high stick on Marty St. Louis. Nesterov to the sin bin. Rangers onto the power play. Guess who took advantage?
Good play by Dan Boyle. Across to Derek Brassard. And now a shot, score! Marty St. Louis, his first of the playoffs.
Let's experience that sequence at ice level. That strike by St. Louis ending the longest goal drought of his postseason career, 15 games. Then with 8.5 minutes left, Rick Nash continuing to provide for his team. The fifth goal on Friday night after setting up an entourage screening on Thursday night. This tuck in between the legs of Ben Bishop. 5 goals for the Rangers and 2 for Nash, his first multi-goal playoff game ever. And how about the King, Henrik Lundqvist, bouncing back to lead his team to victory this series, even at 2 apiece. Let's head inside a very happy Rangers dressing room.
Yeah! Yeah! Great job, boys. Good team effort tonight, all around. Marty, great game. Good speed all night, Hank. Right? But going to the Slim Reaper. Let's realize what we have, boys. Something special.
And this performance by Nash was special. 2 goals in this game after scoring just 2 total goals in the previous 15 playoff games he'd played this postseason. This 4-goal margin of victory for New York snapped an NHL record streak of 12 straight 1-goal playoff wins by the Rangers.